Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see a very interesting question which is frequently asked in the interviews: find missing number in an array. So the problem goes like this. You have an array having n-1 elements, and each element of the array can range from 1 to n, okay, and there are no duplicate elements. Now what you need to find is, find the missing number, the number which is not present between this range 1 to n. Let us suppose this is our array. Then our missing number is, you can see that 4 is our missing number, okay, because the value of n is 5 and our array elements range will be from 1 to 5. Now you can see that 1, 2, 3, 5 is present but 4 is not present. So let us look at the first method in order to solve it. We will discuss about 3 methods, okay. So the first method will be by using hashing, okay. So let us see how can we solve it by using hashing. What you need to do is, first we will create a hash map of value n plus 1, okay. So here you can see that n's value is 5, so we need from 0 to 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5, okay. Now according to our given condition, we have elements from 1 to n. We will assign every element to be false, okay. Initially no element is present. Now what we will do is, we will start iterating from the first element and we will loop through all the elements. Now you can see that in the first place 1 is present. So what we will do is, we will mark it true. That means 1 is present. Now we will move on to the next element. 2 is present, so we will mark here true. Now 3 is present, we will mark here true. 4 is not present, 5 is present, so we will mark here true. Okay. Now what we will do is, we can start either checking from this position, that means from 1, and iterate through the right hand side, or we can start from the last element and iterate through left hand side, okay. Whichever element is marked as false will be our missing number, okay. So you can see that 4 is still false here. So we can find the missing number by this method, and the time in order to do it by hashing will be order of n. Since we are assigning the values to this hash map by looping through all the elements in an array, and there are n-1 elements, so the time complexity will be order of n. And what will be the space complexity? The space complexity will be order of n, since we are using extra space which is for the hash map, okay. Now let us look at a better solution. Let us look at method 2. So in method 2, this is our better solution. This is by using the sum formula, okay. Sum formula. So if you can see here, our array is 1 2 3 5. So let me draw the array again. 1 2 3 5, okay, this is our array, and then our indices were 0 1 2 3, okay. Now you can see that the sum of n natural numbers will be equals to n into n plus 1 by 2, okay, and here n is equals to 5, okay. So what will be the value? 5 into 6 by 2, which will be 6 5s are 30, and by 2 it will be 15, okay. So this will be the sum of n natural numbers. Now what you need to do is, you need to loop through all these elements and find the sum value, and this will be the sum of the array. The sum of the array will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 5, and this will be equals to 5 plus 3 8 plus 2 10 plus 1, it will be 11, okay. Now what you need to do is, finding the missing number will be very simple. You can do SN minus SA, that means sum of n natural numbers minus sum of the elements of the array, and that will be 15 minus 11, and this will come out to be 4. So this will be our answer. Now the time complexity for this algorithm will be order of n. Why? We are finding this S of n in just order of one time by using this formula, okay. And we are finding the sum of the array in order of n time, since we have to iterate through each and every element of the array, and this is taking order of n time, and subtracting the values will take just order of one time. Therefore the time complexity will be order of n, and the space complexity will be just order of one, since we are not using any extra space. Therefore we can say that this sum formula is better than the approach we had seen by using hashing, okay. But this is not the best solution. We can have overflow issues in this method too. We can have overflow issues. How? Because we are actually adding the elements. So if this array elements are very large, then overflow may occur, integer overflow may occur. Okay, so you need to handle out this case. Now let us look at the third method, which is the most efficient one, and therefore there is no overflow in this method, and this method is XOR method. Now how can you do it by using XOR? So let us take our same example, 1, 2, 3 and 5. Okay, this was our array and our indices were 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now what we will do is, we will take the array having n elements. That means we will assume the array having n elements, and this would have been 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are all the elements. Okay, what we will do is, we will calculate the XOR between first n natural numbers and the elements of the array. So what we will do is, we will XOR 1, XOR 2, XOR 3, XOR 5. These are the XOR between the numbers in an array, and then we will XOR it with the n natural numbers. 1 XOR 2, XOR 3, XOR 4, XOR 5. Okay. And this will give out the answer as 4. How will it give out to be answer as equals to the missing number? Because you know that if we XOR a value, say x, with the same value x, then it will come out to be 0. Because if we write the bitwise representation of this x and this x, it will come out to be the same. So let us take an example of 5. So 5 can be represented as 101. Okay, so this is 5. And if we XOR it with 101, then what will be the result? This 11 will be 0, this 00 will be 0, and 11 will be 0. So it will be 00 and 0. Only if the corresponding bits are different, that means if it is 0 and this is 1, or this is 1 and this is 0, then only the answer will come out here to be 1. Okay, so if we are doing XOR between the same elements, then the answer will always be 0. Therefore, you can see that this is 1 and this is 1, this is 2 and this is 2. So when we are doing XOR between the elements of the array and the first n natural numbers, then you can see that pair of elements will be formed, and only the element which is missing in this array will be left behind. Okay, so this will be our answer. So this XOR method will take order of n time. Okay, this will take order of n time, and this will take a space complexity of just order of 1. And here there is no overflow case. We do not have overflow by using the XOR method. So this is the best as far as we have done. We have covered up three methods. First, by using the hashing method. This is also very simple, but it is taking extra space. Now the second method was by using the sum formula. This is also very simple. It is taking a time of order of n and space of order of 1. But there is an overflow issue. Okay. So by using the XOR method, you are avoiding overflow issue, as well as you are not using any extra space. So this is the best method as far as we know. I hope you were able to understand how to find the missing number in an array. If you have any type of doubt, then please comment below. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.